New Zealand captain Ken Rutherford looked a good skipper in the losing side in Australia. Here at Lord's on the fourth day of this Cornhill Test, he has a chance to become a winner. The New Zealanders have played very, very well so far in this game. Welcome to the highlights of the fourth day's play. It's been an enthralling match so far, three very good days of cricket. This is the way the fourth day began. New Zealand 476 all out, England 281, and New Zealand 195 runs ahead. Here now, with his pitch report for the fourth day, is Geoffrey Boycott.
Well, let's have a look at this end where all the wickets have fallen. Most of them to the seamers. Nice firm bounce sometimes, and then occasionally, look like that, it bounces quite high. And they're getting this bounce from just short of a length. There's nothing really to see, except these cracks opening wider. Lovely covering of grass. But really, you can't see any reason why the odd ball bounces and seems a bit more than normal. Lovely cracks everywhere. If we pop down the other end, I think the spinner will be doing quite a bit of bowling into these footmarks. Just a few footmarks here. Paul Taylor's run through, left arm over. I think Such will be trying to bowl into these a little bit and trying to create a few problems, particularly for the right-hand batsman. All in all, still a good pitch for batting, just that it's an overcast day. The seamers should still get a bit of movement now and again.
Ken Rutherford will be looking for a declaration with a lead of something around about 400 late in the afternoon. I think he'd also like to have the chance of bowling at England for something like an hour this evening. We join play now with the third ball of the day. Fraser is the bowler. He's coming in from the pavilion end. Brian Young is taking strike. One run on the board. And he's away. He's away with a four. Nice positive approach when you're on a pair.
This was a gorgeous shot. Lovely footwork early in the morning. Right to the pitch of the ball.
Oh, a ball. No great amount of bounce there, but I think he did him for pace as well.
Well, there's no chance of this. Brian Young just nearly crept along the ground. If that had been straight, I don't think he'd have saved himself. And I don't think there would be many batsmen who would have done.
Give it in. Give it in. Pocock is gone. Steve Buckner very sensibly took his time about that decision. Worked out all the angles. Was Pocock playing a shot? Was he outside off stump when the ball struck him? And in the end, he has raised the dreaded finger.
Yes, I thought that Blair Pocock just fell over a little bit, his balance. He can do that, can the slope at Lord's. It affects you when you're not used to it. He got too far over. He was way outside the line of the ball, and then he had to try and get around his pad to get to it, and I think the umpire had to study the line, and it was a reasonably good decision in the end. Ken Rutherford, the captain.
First blood of the morning to Philip Contratus. Good breakthrough for him once again. Oh, dear me. That's kept low, and Contratus is on a hat-trick. Beaten for pace and certainly beaten by the lack of bounce.
Well, that was a cruel ball to get. First up, just trying to get yourself settled. It's quick, it's straight, and it dies on you, keeps low. I mean, you've no chance of these. I mean, look, it's hit him, oh, just above the shin, round about shin height. It's straight. Cruel.
Now then, Martin Crowe. England have struck twice. Hat-trick ball coming up. Oh, bowl. Well played too by Martin Crowe. A little touch of experience. From Martin Crowe.
Wow, it's lovely cricket. Thrown up nice and wide, tempting the batsman, but the batsman's in good form. Confidence high from his century in the first innings. A classic loft drive.
Good shot again. That's better than the first one in the server. Beautiful stroke. Lovely to watch. 23 for 2 now. Oh, wow, look at that.
No stroke. And over they go. Well, we've seen so many of these at Lord's. Just saying how much of a problem Martin Crowe might be having with his balance out there. Bowled to Freitas for 9, 29 for 3.
Well, certainly beautifully bowled, and Martin Crowe may have misjudged the line a little bit there, and again the ball just may have held up instead of running away towards the slips. Martin Crowe thinking that the ball would run away, and perhaps it just kept holding its line and he's misjudged it. Beautifully bowled, and so Philip de Freitas is causing New Zealanders just a few problems out there this morning. So De Freitas with 3 for 14. Well, that's a great start for him. And, of course, for England, too. And that just slows the momentum as far as New Zealand are concerned.
That's a lovely shot. Beautifully played. It's Atherton and Fraser decided to move the fine leg squarer. That was their last move in the field, and that's whipped round fine. 4 runs, flashes away down to the nursery end.
It's a nice shot, nicely timed. It really is a feature of Brian Young's batting, that when he gets onto the back foot like that, it really is a question of effortless ease.
You'll see where that cover is, very square indeed.
Well, nothing wrong with that either. That's probably a better shot. That'll make Philip de Freitas and Mike Atherton think about that offside feel, but two lovely shots in succession from Brian Young. 50 for 3.
Well, it's a very tempting gap that England are giving Brian Young, and it's tempted him enough that he's just smacked two off Philip de Freitas. Beautiful shots.
Lovely shot from Stephen Fleming. He really is at his best when he gets that bat to flow through as straight as that. It's right on top of the ball, and it really is a free-flowing shot.
Well, it's a cracking off drive. He likes to play shots and he likes to play through the line of the ball. This time it was perfectly played.
Fine shot. Absolutely dead straight down the ground. And Brian Young looks in very good touch this morning.
Well, this is a nice, gentle loosener from Craig White. It's pitched up right in the slot. And there's not much margin for error on this pitch, especially when you're only medium pace like Craig White.
That's a good shot. That's the exuberance of youth. Spinning away from the left-hander, coming over the wicket. the air, but safe, and that'll be four. He's an interesting young player, Fleming. He doesn't hang back. Bowling something a bit offline, a bit wide or a bit short, and he gives it some real hammer.
Yes, he's the sort of middle-order player who's not going to be tied down by any bowler. Occasionally it's going to be his downfall, but he's also going to be very positive and get on top of the bowling. He plays a lot of good shots.
Leading edge. Smith would have been watching the turn of the bat, which was aiming the ball towards the onside.
Well, Stephen Fleming, he's not happy facing spin. Rather faced a quicker bowler, and just turning the ball, turning the bat against the spin of the ball there, and just trying to work it on the onside.
Yes, they'll be pushing up towards a 300 lead at lunch, and I'd have thought the declaration would be pondered between lunch and tea. Chance of making, say, another 90. They could have a lead of 375 to 400 by the time tea comes, providing they bat well enough. And that's the sort of thing they'll be intent on doing.
Well, Brian Young has now just hit his 8th four in his 43. And it's very pleasing to see an opening batsman get the ball to the boundary. And the thing is that his timing, his execution, his concentration, I mean, it's all there. And it's just not brute strength or anything of that nature. He's just laid back on this occasion and just played it beautifully square.
Shot. Beautiful stroke. We'll see nothing better than that. The off spinner slightly overpitched and the batsman got right into it.
Well, he has played very well, Brian Young, this morning.
No more runs added. The New Zealanders 87 for 3 at lunch. They lost those three early ones. Then a nice recovery, with Brian Young playing very well indeed for his 48. And also Stephen Fleming confirming his promise, 87 for 3, and the bowling figures, just the three wickets there for De Freitas at a cost of 29 from 8 overs. Nothing else for the England bowlers. And the state of play at lunch on the fourth day, England 281 and New Zealand now 87 for 3, a lead of 282. Three runs have been added as we join play after lunch. Philip De Freitas is bowling around the wicket, and Stephen Fleming is taking strike.
Pretty loose shot from Fleming. Gave himself a little extra room to try and force it through the offside. He was really guessing at the bounce, and the ball flew away between the slips. It's a very well played 51. And without him this morning, New Zealand could have been in a very sorry state. Well, that's beautifully placed. Tossed up by Peter Such. Plenty of flight in that delivery. Just slightly overdone.
Well, it's a super shot. I was just saying a few minutes ago, if you give him anything off length, he really is going to clatter it, this young man. Very refreshing outlook.
Just dropping short. Again, De Freitas finding the edge. He's only able to take it on the half volley.
Freitas has caused Fleming all sorts of problems coming around the wicket. Made a miss of the few. He's nicked a couple. He's got runs through that vacant third slip area.
Well,
beautiful stroke.
That's Brian Young's 11th boundary in his 64. So 44 runs have come in boundaries from Brian Young, and that is excellent batting.
Safe and four, even better.
Not for the bowler, though.
Well, there's only one slip in there, and that's Graham Hick. And had a second slip been in position, then that might well have been out. And of course, Atherton has to go on the defensive. Keep the New Zealand batsmen out there as long as possible and deny them runs, and of course that reduces the England batting time, of course. But they're very handy runs for Brian Young in New Zealand.
Very good stroke. Two glorious shots in this over from Brian Young. Hundred stand between Young and Fleming. Fleming's made 37 of those. Beautiful shot off his pads. Looking more and more complete player, Brian Young.
Well, that was well bowled. It was a slower ball. It prompted the drive from Brian Young, and he chipped it in the air, so it was very well bowled, but it hit space and it hit the fence. That's a big shout, and that's out. Stephen Fleming scored 39. A fine partnership with Brian Young. Never quite found his normal fluency. And it's a wicket for Paul Taylor.
Who said Paul Taylor should have been bowling before? Well, it's a nice innings by Stephen Fleming, and a really good wicket for Paul Taylor, because I'm sure he really must have been down a little bit inside thinking, why doesn't the captain give me a bowl? I think I'm worth a bowl or two, and here it is, a straight ball angling across, pitching outside off stump. Stephen Fleming trying to whip it across that front pad, and the umpire saying you can't do that straight ball.
.144 for 4. Beautiful shot. Used the speed of the ball. No turn from Peter Such, and chopped away fine. That's the shot of a man in form. Well, that's gone fine. I think he aimed it square. Rather a hard crack on the bat, might just have hit the toe end of the bat, gone very fine for 4 runs.
very firmly struck. Just one bounce and four, straight down the ground to the nursery end.
Nice footwork here too by Shane Thompson, just coming down the crease and hitting the ball dead straight. Getting to the half volley, deny the ball from spinning. Just get under it and hit it dead straight over the bowler's head. Well, that's a nice shot.
Lords, Ascot. Makes no difference.
It's high in the air. Peter Sutch is underneath it and drops it. Well, Peter Sutch had to make about 7 or 8 yards in and slightly to his right to get underneath that. And you can see the pain etched into his face.
Well, three people would have had the heart in their mouths. One would have been Angus Fraser, the bowler. Another one, Brian Young, the batsman, who's on 91. And Peter Sutch, who's just spilled it. Well.
Good fielding. Philip de Freitas very quick away to his right. Philip de Freitas would like to take on the responsibilities of umpire as well as strike bowler. He can't quite tell from there.
Well,
we can from here.
That's a sharp catch. Peter Sutch has drifted away from the bat. Brian Young has gone. The gesture he made as he realised the ball had been caught indicates the intense disappointment. Made naught in the first innings and 94 in the second. That was a good catch.
Well, he's not the first player to be got out by a lunch or tea break. To start again after a night's sleep, and he'll not be the last. It usually is the undoing of a lot of players. Great disappointment for Brian Young because he's played superbly.
Adam Karori coming out to join Shane Thompson. Thompson on 14, Karori about to face Peter Sutch. 12 extras and 170 for 5. Didn't quite get it as he wanted, but it was still a pretty good shot. No one seems to be pulling the ball down in this match. It's all with an upward swing of the bat. Oh, well. I love the way Steve Buckner says no. Does it with the same good humour as he says yes, you must go. Beautiful time. Kept getting away from him. That has gone at a tremendous rate. Gully is deep. Went past him like a bullet.
The shots are coming now. First a classical cover drive, then a magnificent back cut shot.
Just have got a fingertip on that. Hick, greatest fielder.
Well, this is a very good spell for New Zealand. Runs coming quite quickly. First off the seamer, Angus Fraser, now off the spinner.
Yeah,
And when you see deliveries like that, that will give a great deal of encouragement to the New Zealand bowlers. Absolute jaffer. Well bowled, Angus Fraser. Just comes from nowhere, just short of a length. Rises, bounces, leaves the batsman.
Well, that looks a nasty bump, the point of the shoulder. Two runs ahead, and well, the consensus I think in the commentary box is that New Zealand would like something like 420, 430 runs maybe. Well, the umpire signals dead ball.
Well, that's a bit interesting. Helmet being knocked off the head. If it had fallen on the wickets, of course, then Shane Thompson would have been out, hit wicket.
And that's it. That is the declaration. New Zealand 406 runs ahead. Well played, Shane Thompson, 38 not out. Adam Parori, 15 not out.
That's quite a good declaration from Ken Rutherford, 211 for 5. They moved along fairly briskly, just tied down towards the end, and England did a good job. Their bowlers worked very, very hard out there. 3 for 63 for De Freitas. That was a great burst he had early in the morning. 1 for 55 for Peter Such. And Paul Taylor, I thought, much underused. 6 overs, 2 maidens, and 1 for 18. Craig White there bowled just 4 overs, 1 maiden, none for 21. Had to leave the field. Had a shoulder injury. His shoulder clicked and then became quite painful. They're hoping it is just some soft tissue problem and nothing that'll be in any way long term. So the bowling figures there, and England need 407 runs to win. That's why it's a good declaration. That will be the highest ever fourth innings total to win a match if England managed to get up. So history and tradition is against them. We join play in the first over. Michael Atherton is taking strike. Dion Nash is the bowler. No runs on the board so far for England.
The bowls. Just enough movement up the hill for Dion Nash. Hasn't really got loose yet. Hasn't built himself up to full pace.
There was a low ball, but he just managed to get enough buck on it with one hand, and it shot away for four.
Well, it's a good piece of readjustment and almost re-timing. Whatever Mike Allison did was certainly good enough. Great shot. Stewart really does get into position very quickly to play those shots. And there was a definite crack of the bat as he made contact.
I think this is what you call dispatching the long hop. He really belts this right off the meat.
That'll be four more too. Nicely played. Deliberately angle the bat to aim it down towards third man.
There again, you see, we've had everything in the space of just three and a bit overs. Four balls,
good balls, bounces. It's a beauty, isn't it, going down the hill.
Good delivery is going to cost him runs. Callison did well to keep it down again. Needed a little bit of adjustment. A little dropping of the wrists. And Ken Rutherford entitled to clap his bowler. It was a good delivery. That was a very controlled pull shot from Alex Stewart. Not so much a pull, really, as a flick.
Well, it was a good shot to really keep it away from the two men out, but not a very good ball.
Stewart has proved that he's pretty quick onto that shot. I think even Michael Owens might realise different tactics are required.
And it's round about this stage at 30 for none with the ball rushing around off the middle of the bat, where Ken Rutherford's just having a thought as to whether he declared a little bit too early. After that, for that very good ball that Michael Atherton just got down on and steered through the gap, not always intentional, just dropped the hands very nicely, but Ken Rutherford's going to have to think about a third man.
More enthusiasm than accuracy. And the result is a spate of runs. I think the English batsmen are enjoying this little spell at the moment. Pretty up for England, and Abbott and Stewart have batted very well. Four from their wicket. And once again, too short. A very expensive lesson at the moment out there for the New Zealanders. After all, they're the ones that have got to do it. And it's Atherton and Stewart that are leading the way at the moment.
Won't get that. Played off the pad, and Alex Stewart has given those two close-in men a very, very old-fashioned look. England have survived there and survived in style.
That's a very good performance from Atherton and Stewart to get along there to 56 for no wicket at the close of play on this fourth day. Very good effort, 29 and 25 for Stewart. Stewart played some handsome strokes off the back foot. I thought the bowling was too short for much of the time. Nash, 5 overs to 31, underlines that. Owens, 3 overs for 17. Hart bowled well again and got some spin. That'll be significant for tomorrow
Pringle two overs, two maidens, and has been warned for running on the pitch, and Shane Thompson hasn't yet bowled. So the state of game at the end of the fourth day in this Cornhill Test match, 476 all out, 211 for 5, 281 and 56 for Norton, another 351 runs needed for victory. It sounds like an intriguing last day, Geoffrey.
Yes, today was an exciting and unpredictable day, as the others have been. New Zealand, looking for quick runs, got off to a bad start. Philip de Freitas' early 3 wickets really set them back quite a pace. They never really came to grips with the quick scoring needed. They struggled along quite nicely until the declaration came. But all in all, I think that Ken Rutherford would have liked 20, 30 or even 40 runs more when he gave England an awkward 50 minutes at the end of the day. England scored very quickly indeed. Fast scoring, poor bowling, was exciting for the crowd. And it's left the match in a very delicate position. New Zealand can win tomorrow, but so can England. A case of a little history, you could see 407 looks a big total. But the way Gooch, Stuart Atherton, Smith, fast scorers all have an opportunity tomorrow to put the game beyond New Zealand and really do something special for English cricket.
Yes, England certainly could create a little bit of history tomorrow. My own view is that they won't be able to do it. It's a very, very tall task, and a good psychological blow by Kenny Rutherford to set them 407 to win. This is the table of the best wins over the years for teams batting fourth. The fourth innings totals there, 406 for four. India against West Indies, Port of Spain, way back in 1975-76. Australia against England at Headingley, they made 404 to win. New Zealand's best, not so long ago, it was 324 for five against Pakistan in Christchurch. They were batting there, they're in the field tomorrow, and England really have to do well tomorrow to get up, I believe, even to 350. I think they can save the game, but I doubt if they're going to win it. So there is a chance for both England and New Zealand. England to save it, New Zealand to win it, so far as I'm concerned. We look forward to bringing you the action on the final day. This is the way it's going to be tomorrow on BBC One at 10:55 a.m, the final day of this Cornhill Test match, and a very, very exciting day in prospect. For the moment, from Lords, it's goodbye.
Well, in fact, you can see highlights of the final day's play in the second test at the later than build time of midnight tomorrow night here on BBC One.